If you're familiar with Fintel at all, you've probably heard of the short squeeze leaderboard. Well, now we have a thing called a gamma squeeze leaderboard. And this is basically trying to identify potential gamma squeezes. And so I'm going to explain to you what a gamma squeeze is in as simple terms as I can get it to you. Basically, the idea behind a gamma squeeze is it's like a short squeeze in that the price of an underlying stock is going to go up precipitously because of market conditions. And specifically, the market conditions are that there's a whole bunch of call options being bought. And what happens whenever you buy a call option is that there's a market maker on the other side of that transaction. And that market maker is going to sell you the call option. But if there's a whole bunch of call options that are bought, the market maker, who is trying to remain market neutral, has to reduce his risk of delivering those shares. And so he's going to go out and he's going to buy a bunch of the underlying shares. And that will cause the share price to go up. So by buying a lot of call options, what happens is that the market makers are then forced to buy the underlying in order to reduce their risk in case they have to deliver those shares. That's how that works. And so what we're doing here is we're looking at short-dated options, specifically all the options that are due on the upcoming Friday. So in this case, this coming Friday is March 4th. And so we're looking at all the call options dated for the 4th, the expiration of the 4th. So we look at the open interest. In this case, it's 145,000 contracts. And we look at the 7-day volume. Okay, so we're not just looking at this the one day. We're looking at 7-day volume. And then we're basically taking that and we're trying to create a ratio here. But really what we're trying to find is a lot of volume that's abnormal. And one way that a lot of people look at abnormal volume is to basically compare the volume to the open interest. So if you have like a day's volume, which is where the volume is 2 or 3 times the open interest, then that's significant. That's considered to be unusual. We're looking at 7 days, so it's not exactly comparable, but what's more important is that we're looking at the ratio here and we're sorting this by the ratio. So in this scenario, we have a situation where in the last 7 days, 8.5 times the open interest has been bought, and that's significant. And so really what we're trying to do is we're trying to kind of give you a starting point to look at gamma squeezes. And I always say this anytime I get on the webinars, these screeners and these leaderboards, they're all starting points. They should never be ending points for your due diligence. You come here, you get some ideas, you do some more research, you verify the numbers, you make sure that they mean what they think you mean, and then you make your trade, right? You don't ever just look at something and go, oh, you know, and stop there and then make your trade. You always want to do that. And that's just not just for Fintel, that's for any website. Anytime you look at a screener or any kind of aggregator, always check your numbers, check your references, cross-check the numbers, because mistakes happen and, you know, nobody wants to make a trade based on bad data. So this is our first look at the gamma squeezes. We're pretty excited about it because I don't think anybody else is doing this. And we've had a lot of good luck with the short squeeze leaderboard, and hopefully this is going to be useful to people like the short squeeze leaderboard has become.